Hey, hey, welcome to Half the Battle.
Today, I'm here to talk to you about Blaster, an Autobot who...
Okay, let's stop right there. I'm not doing the same joke 2 weeks in a row.
However, this does show us how much Hasbro likes to reuse names across their toy lines. It makes sense, really. If you've already got the rights to a name, you can use it for other stuff, too. The problem is that if a name is well recognized, like with Shockwave, and then they use the name for a G.I. Joe character, well, it just seems cheap and unoriginal. Anyway, we're gonna take a look at the G.I. Joe called Blaster.
Which means we have to go back! Back to the future! All the way to the year 2000!
Battle Force 2000! Battle Force 2000!
Yes, he was part of Battle Force 2000, that ill-fated team with so-called futuristic weapons. The figure itself was released in 1987 with all original body parts. And I have to say straight off the bat, I like it. I like it a lot. In fact, this is my favorite figure from Battle Force 2000. The overall color scheme is great, and so is the design. It's futuristic, but still believable. There's lots of nice little detailing, like all the techie stuff on his helmet and the blue patch on his leg. I have no freaking idea what any of it is supposed to do, but it looks cool. Well, if you go by the card art, I suppose this thing is a flashlight, I guess. Another thing that's cool is that, unlike the other guy from Battle Force 2000 we looked at, Avalanche, this guy doesn't have a Liefeld-esque physique, and he has no excessive pouches either. That's a relief. I'll be the first to admit, the figure isn't perfect, though. There are some flaws. The helmet isn't removable, and it is prone to having the paint rubbed off, like on mine here. Also, the black straps on his waist and upper legs make it look like he's wearing girdle straps on top of his pants. I don't know, maybe he just really, really likes the Rocky Horror Picture Show. He only comes with two accessories. This is actually pretty common in the Battle Force 2000 line. They all just come with one or two accessories. That's because they're vehicle drivers. Even though they don't come with vehicles. Nope, never gonna stop bitching about that. His first accessory is a mouthpiece that complements the figure nicely and looks great on him. But it is very easy to lose or break due to the size of it and the tiny, tiny pegs that hold it in place. His second accessory is, well, this thing. Yeah, I don't know what to tell ya. It's called a laser gun, but it looks like it's a missile launcher too. Sure is weird though. The main problem with it is the handle. It's a little bit too big, and I'm afraid that if I put it in his hand, it might damage his thumbs. As for its actual function, well, I guess it could be some kind of microwave gun. But that's just conjecture from what I've seen on the file card.
Speaking of which, let's look at the file card! I am truly the master of segues.
His primary speciality is ground effect vehicles. In this case, that means he's Battle Force 2000's Vindicator driver. It's actually two vehicles in one. A hovercraft that can launch a small plane-like thing. He is also a microwave technician. That's why I figure his weird gun is a microwave weapon. I'm assuming he's an expert on the military application, not on heating up hot pockets. As far as his personality goes, Blaster has been obsessed with hovercraft from an early age. He started designing and making them himself at age 13 with the help of popular mechanics. That's a weird bit of product placement there. Not as weird as Coke, but still. Anyway, Blaster had a problem. He found that the world just wasn't ready for his radical new hovercraft ideas. So he offered them to the military. The world just isn't ready, man!
I use the same excuse for why I don't have millions of fans. The world simply isn't ready for my sheer genius!
The file card mentions that he's into hovercraft to the point of obsession, but that's okay, because who isn't obsessed about something?
I make a joke here, but I am the guy with almost 3,000 action figures. So, glass houses and all that.
Blaster nor Battle Force 2000 appeared in the cartoon shows, so there's nothing to talk about there. He did appear in the comics, and we have to once again go to issue 68 for his debut, as well as that of Battle Force 2000. They are called a Special Research and Testing Unit. In this issue, they have set up a base in Frozenland, another made-up country. Without the Joe's knowledge, that entire nation is being bombarded by Cobra's fear and paranoia waves, making everybody, well, cranky, for lack of a better word. Blaster is actually the one who figures it all out. He observed his friends acting all pissed off, while he himself was unaffected. And after seeing some Cobras wearing ear protection, he correctly deduced that they were using some kind of sonic weapon. He wasn't affected because he listens to rock and roll on his headphones. I mean the music, not the character. So, thanks to Blaster, they take out all the Cobra operations in Frozenland and save the necks of the Joes operating there. All in all, a strong debut. Then, a little later, he dies in the Battle of Benzene, with most of the rest of Battle Force 2000. That's why we only ever got one toy of him.
God damn it.
Well, that was Blaster. In conclusion, a great figure. Easily the best of the bunch out of Battle Force 2000. And when I was a kid, I always made him the leader of that group. And I also made him have the same command position in G.I. Joe as Beachhead had.
And hey, he's an obsessive nerd. That's something I'm sure a few of us can relate to. Well, see you next week, everybody!
Transformers, more than meets the eye. Autobots waste their power to destroy the evil.